Today I'm going to show you some sample solutions to some of the important sums based on addition and subtraction of two matrices. यानी इस वीडियो में मैं आपको दूंगा कुछ सैम्पल सॉल्यूशंस ऐसे सवालों के जो बेस्ड हैं एडिशन एंड सब्ट्रैक्शन ऑफ टू मैट्रिसेस पर. सो कीप वॉचिंग दिस वीडियो टिल द एंड. सो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन वी हैव टेकन, फाइंड द सम एंड देर आर टू मैट्रिसेस ऑफ इक्वल ऑर्डर एंड लेट मी रिमाइंड यू that sum and difference of two matrices is only possible when their orders are same. Yani ki do matrices add ya subtract ki ja sakti hain only in the condition that both the matrices should have the same order. Yani agar do matrices ke number of rows and number of columns equal hote hain tabhi unko add ya subtract kiya ja sakta hai. So we have taken a very simple sum because this is the first sum of this segment. So here we have to add these two 3x3 matrices together. So simply what we have to do, we have to add the corresponding elements. That means 1-1 element should be added to the 1-1 element of the other matrix. 1-2 element is added to 1-2 element, 1-3 element is added to 1-3 element. In this way we have to add all these elements. So minus 1 plus 12, first element of the sum, 4 plus 7, minus 6 plus 6, and here 8 plus 8. 8 plus 8, 5 plus 0, and here 16 plus 5, and 2 plus 3, 8 plus 2, 5 plus 4. That's it. Just simplify. So matrix plus 12 minus 1 plus 11, both are positive, 4 and 7, 11, and here minus 6 and plus 6 becomes 0, 8 plus 8, 16, 5 plus 0, 5, 16 plus 5, 21, 3 plus 2, 5, 8 plus 2, 10, and 5 plus 4, 9. So this is the solution of simple sum. So what we have to do here, we have to write down these two matrices, these two equations as equation number 1 and equation number 2. So as you see, in equation number 1, the coefficient of x is 2 and coefficient of y is 3, and here the coefficient of x is 3 and coefficient of y is 2. So in the next step, what we have to do, we have to multiply equation number 1 and equation number 2 with different two numbers in such a way that either the coefficients of x become same or coefficients of y become same. So let's make the coefficient of y same. So to do that, we have to multiply equation number 1 by 2, so we get here 6 because 2 3 is 6, and we have to multiply equation number 2 by 3 so that here we get 6, 3 2 is 6. So multiplying equation number 1 by 2 and multiplying equation number 2 by 3, we get, multiply equation number 1 by 2, 2 2's are 4, we get 4x plus 3 2's are 6, 6y is equal to 2 matrix 2 3 4 0. And here multiplying equation number 2 by 3, so we have 9x plus 3 2 is a 6y is equal to 3, and matrix 2 minus 2 minus 1, 5. So here first we have to multiply this matrix by 2 and this matrix by 3. And this is the multiplication of a matrix by a scalar. And we know well, when we multiply a matrix by a scalar, that scalar multiplies each and every element of that matrix as per rule. So we multiply each and every element of this matrix by 2, because this is multiplied by 2. So we get 4, 6, 8, 0. And same way, in the second equation, we have to multiply this matrix by 3. So we get 3 to the 6 minus 6, 3 minus 1 minus 3, 3, 5 is a 15. So now what we have to do, the next step is the terms whose coefficients, scalar coefficients of whose are equal in magnitude. Here we have made the coefficient of y same. If these two terms have the same sign, negative negative or positive positive, we have to subtract them. That means we have to change the signs of this equation. And if these two signs are opposite, we have to add them so that these two terms are cancelled. So here the case is both the equations have the same signs of these two terms. So we have to subtract them. So change the signs here, positive. If nothing is written, that is considered to be positive. So we have to minus over here, here plus, there is minus, and here is plus, here should be minus. Now plus 6y minus 6y are cancelled, and here we get 4x positive and 9x negative, so we get minus 5x. And on the right hand side, this minus this, because we have changed the sign of this matrix and it becomes negative, and if there is nothing written before this matrix, it is considered to be positive. So the matrix 4, 6, 8, 0 minus matrix 6 minus 6 minus 3 plus 15. So now simplifying right hand side, we get 4 minus 6. 6 minus minus becomes plus, so we get 6 plus 6. And here 8 minus minus plus 3, so 8 plus 3, and 0 minus 15. 0 minus 15. So we get, proceeding from this step, we get minus 5x is equal to, and on the right hand side the matrix is first element 4 minus 6 minus 2 and 6 plus 6 12, and here 8 plus 3 11, and here 0 minus 15 is 15 minus 15. Now we have to transpose this minus 5 to right hand side to find the value of x, so we get minus 1 upon 5, and matrix minus 2, 12, 11, minus 15. And as you know, this is the scalar, and scalar multiplication of matrix is carried out in such a way that each and every element of the matrix is multiplied by that scalar. So minus 2 into minus 1 upon 5, we get 2 upon 5. Minus 1 upon 5 into 12, we get minus 12 upon 5. Minus 1 upon 5 into 11, we get minus 11 upon 5. And minus 1 upon 5 into minus 15, we get 3, because minus into minus becomes plus, and 5 will divide 15 3 times, so simply 3 we get. So here we get x is equal to the matrix 2 by 5 minus 12 by 5 and minus 11 by 5 and 3. So now we are going to substitute the value of x in this equation. So we get 2 into matrix 2 by 5 minus 12 by 5 minus 11 by 5 and 3, matrix closed, plus 3y is equal to matrix 2, 3, 4, 0. Then we multiply by this 2, and in the same way as we have done earlier, we have to multiply each and every element of this matrix by 2. We get 4 upon 5 and minus 12 into 2 minus 24 upon 5. Minus 11 upon 5 into 2 minus 22 upon 5 and 2 into 3, 6 plus 3y as it is equal to matrix 2, 3, 4, 0 as it is. Now we transpose this matrix to right hand side to make this term alone because we have to find the value of y. So 3y is left on the left hand side, and on the right hand side we get the matrix 2, 3, 4, 0 minus matrix 4 upon 5 minus 24 upon 5 minus 22 upon 5 and 6. So now here we have to subtract simply. So corresponding elements are subtracted from each other. Then we have to subtract first element from first element. So we get 2 minus 4 upon 5, and here 3 minus minus plus, because this minus and this minus will multiply and we get 3 plus 24 upon 5. 4 minus into minus plus, so we get 4 plus 22 upon 5, and at last 0 minus 6. 0 minus 6. So let's simplify, and we have to transpose this 3 to right hand side. We get y is equal to 1 upon 3, and the matrix, simplify this, we have to take the LCM of 5. We get 5 to the 10 minus 4, 6 upon 5, and here we have to take 5 LCM, 5 3 is 15 plus 24, we get 39 upon 5. Here we have to take LCM, we get 5 for the 20, 20 plus 22, 42 upon 5, and 0 minus 6, 6. Now, multiplying this matrix by this scalar, we get matrix 1 upon 3 multiplied by 6 upon 5, we get 2 upon 5, because 3 will divide 6 2 times, and simply we get 2 upon 5. And here in this term, if we multiply 1 upon 3 and 39 upon 5, this 3 will divide 39 13 times, so we get 13 upon 5. And if we multiply 1 upon 3 and 42 upon 5, 3 will divide 42 14 times, so we get 14 upon 5. And if we multiply minus 6 by 1 upon 3, 3 will divide 6 2 times, we get simply minus 2. So this way we find the value of x and y, and that's it. Now the third sum we have taken as 3 into matrix XYZ is equal to matrix x 6 minus 1 2w plus matrix 4 x plus y z plus w 3, and we need to find out the values of x, y, z and w. So this is a matrix equation in which there are three matrices. Some of the elements are numerical and some of the elements are arbitrary, like x, y, z, w, and we have to find the value of x, y, z. This is third type of sum. So let's start. First, what we have to do, we have to simplify and right hand side and left hand side simultaneously, whatever is the required operation. So we have to carry out here multiplication of this matrix by scalar, and as we know, by scalar multiplication of a matrix, we have to multiply each and every element of matrix by that scalar. So we add on the left hand side matrix 3x, 3y, 3z, 3w is equal to. Now here on right hand side, what is required operation? There is only simply addition. We have to add these two matrices together, because both the matrices have the same order, 2 by 2, so may be added. So let's add them. So x plus 4 is the first element we get on adding them, and the second is 6 plus x plus y, and the third is minus 1 plus z plus w, and the last one is 2w plus 3. So we have these two matrices on simplification on both the sides of equality. So there are two matrices of the same order on either side of equality, on opposite side of equality we may say. So in this case, if two matrices are equal, that means if two matrices having the same order have the equal sign between them, it means their corresponding elements must be equal. A11 must be equal to A11, A12 must be equal to A12, and A21 must be equal to A21, and A22 must be equal to A22, otherwise two matrices may not be equal. So if these two matrices are equal, it implies that 3x is equal to x plus 4. It implies that transposing x to this side, we get 2x, because x will be subtracted from the left hand side. On the right hand side, we get only 4, and transposing 2 to right hand side, this will divide 4 and we get x is equal to 2. If we compare these two elements, we get 3y is equal to 6 plus x plus y, and it implies that transposing y to left hand side, it will be subtracted from left hand side, so we get 2y, and on the right hand side we get 6 plus x only, and as you have already calculated the value of x, which is 2, so substituting the value of x here, we get 6 plus 2, and that is it. Now transposing 2 from left hand side to right hand side, it will divide 8, and we get y is equal to 4. Now the next elements are this one and this one. We have to equate them. 3z is equal to minus 1 plus z plus w. So transposing z and w, only z, let's take only z to the left hand side, we get 2z on the left hand side, because this z will be subtracted from, and on the right hand side we have minus 1 plus w. Because we have not found the value of w, so we have to keep this equation at hold. So let it be equation number 1. Now we have to compare the last element, that means A22 to A22. So on the left hand side we get 3w on the right hand side, we have 2w plus 3. So transposing 2w to left hand side, we get only w to the left hand side, because 2w will be subtracted from 3w, and on the right hand side we get only 3. So now we get w is equal to 3. So by substituting the value of w here in this equation, we get 2z is equal to minus 1 plus 3, and minus 1 plus 3 is equal to 2, and transposing this 2 to right hand side, it will divide this 2, and finally we get z is equal to 1. So this way we have found all these required values. So the final summary of this solution is x is equal to 2, y is equal to 4, w is equal to 3, and z is equal to 1. And that's now the next type of sum is where we have to simplify some given expression in terms of addition of two matrices. So here we are given this expression as cos theta into matrix cos theta sin theta minus sin theta cos theta plus sin theta matrix sin theta minus cos theta sin theta, and we have to simplify. So this is a type of sum where we need to simplify some expression where the elements are given in trigonometric forms, and where we can use some trigonometrical identities. So let's start. We have to simplify this expression. So what we have to do first, we have to simply multiply this matrix by cos theta, and here cos theta is considered to be a scalar because this is outside the matrix. So in scalar multiplication of matrix by an element, since each and every element of the matrix is multiplied, so we have to multiply each and every element of this square matrix by this scalar, that is cos theta. So simply what we have, cos theta into cos theta cos square theta. So cos square theta, cos theta into sine theta cos theta. Cos theta into minus sine theta cos theta. And cos theta into cos theta cos square theta. Oh my god, this sounds very bad. Plus, now we have to multiply this matrix by this sign, so each and every element of this matrix is multiplied by the sine theta. So we have sine theta into sine theta sine square theta, sine theta into minus sine theta cos theta, and sine theta into sine theta cos theta, and sine theta into sine theta sine square theta. So multiplying these two matrices by these two scalars, we have two matrices of same order 2 by 2, so we may add them. So we get cos square theta plus sine square theta, first element as cos square theta plus sine square theta. Second element, we have sine theta cos theta plus into minus sine theta cos theta, that is this element, and then this sign will multiply this sign, so plus into minus minus, and we get sine theta cos theta. Now minus sine theta cos theta plus minus sine theta cos theta plus sine theta cos theta, and last element cos square theta plus sine square theta As we know well, in trigonometry, cos square theta plus sine square theta is always equal to 1. So, by that identity, this element becomes 1. And as quite clear, these two elements are opposite in sign, but equal in magnitude. Sine theta, cos theta, sine theta, cos theta, but this is positive and this is negative. So, these two elements are cancelled by each other. Similarly, this sine theta cos theta is negative and this sine theta cos theta positive cancelled. And here again we have to use the same identity, that is 1. Sine square theta plus cos square theta is always equal to 1. So this element becomes 0 and this element becomes 0 and this element becomes 1. So finally we get a matrix 1 0 0 1, which is popularly known as an identity matrix whose diagonal elements are unity and non-diagonal elements are 0, which is generally denoted by I2 or I2/2. That's it. So, aaj ke liye itna hi. Since the topic is very easy, addition and subtraction of matrices is very simple topic. And generally, most of the students used to find this topic is very easy. So there are not a large number of the sums and or we may say the types of sums based on addition and subtraction of the matrices. But in my next video, I'm going to give simple solutions to some of the important sums based on multiplication of matrices. And as you know, multiple of matrices is very important as compared to addition and subtraction of matrices. So there are a large number of the varieties of sums. So keep watching and please like and share my video and subscribe my channel. By the way, thanks for watching this video. Bye for now. Khuda Hafiz.